Excise, actually it's not exercise. I already done that. So I have done this exercise for you. So I compare three companies now here. You can check Xiaomi, Samsung and Lenovo. All are similar businesses. Agree? Xiaomi is also selling laptops and phones and tablets. Samsung is doing the same. Lenovo is also doing the same. But Lenovo has servers, right? Samsung has other electronics, while Xiaomi is purely mobile at the moment. Okay, and the size, so you, now you can look at the size of the company. Is it the size same? Look at the revenue. Even look at the assets. So which one is the biggest company? All are USD millions. So how will you compare which company is doing a better job? Can you say, oh, Samsung is making 101 million, so it's better? By saying that Lenovo is making only 7 million and Xiaomi is only 3 million, so it's not good.
I think you can't look at the ratios.
Yeah, you need to look at the ratios. Correct? So here you look at the ratios, gross profit ratio is 12%, 45% and Lenovo is 14%. So here you will say, okay, actually the Samsung is better in terms of gross profit. It's a better company, right? Because getting higher efficiencies. So if it's a coincidence that the number is the biggest also and their profitability is also biggest. But why Lenovo is, why Samsung is higher profitability compared to Xiaomi? Because Xiaomi makes cheaper phones. They are cost leaders. And Xiaomi is comparatively a new company compared to Samsung, which is already established company. And Samsung has, this number is consolidated number of all their businesses. That is why I said in the initial times that the Lenovo is company which is making phones, laptops, servers. Samsung doesn't make server. Samsung make other electronics, right? They make TV, fridge and everything else, consumer electronics, which is very high profitability. So now you will not be able to compare these three businesses in gross profit just by looking at the total number. Okay, in your resources I gave you the P&L of the two companies, but you cannot just compare them without looking at the deeper details. So what, how will you compare them then? What do you need to know? No. But return on equity, yes. But if you want to know the operating efficiencies of the three companies, what will you do? Does anybody remember yesterday we discussed about cost center, profit center, different businesses? So how will you know? You need to know the profitability of their each different divisions, right? Which can be compared. So Xiaomi is mostly doing the phone business. So you need to understand what is Samsung in the total of $101 billion that they are earning. How much profitability come from mobile division? How much profitability come from the consumer products? How much profitability come from the other businesses, right? Samsung have a lot of range. Correct? And their demographics. Xiaomi works mostly in China and India. Samsung, does it work only in China? No, Samsung go worldwide, right? Samsung is in US. When you are generating a business in Myanmar compared to US, which one you think will be more profitable?
Yeah.
Why?
More
volume. Correct? With the same salesperson, you can maybe generate a higher sales. So every demographics, you will be able to generate a different profitability. Correct? So you not only by the business division, you also need to drop down by the demographics of the business. Correct? By looking at where they are doing the business. So maybe they are doing business in US, so you need to see what is their business operations from US, from China and India. Same goes for Lenovo. Lenovo is also a global company. Plus, they have multiple products. Correct? So you cannot just compare them by looking at their profit and loss statement and say, okay, now my verdict is Samsung is better. Maybe yes, but maybe not. Okay, so the idea is to drill down even deeper into details. Then the next one is property, plant and equipments. Here you can see the Xiaomi is running with only 700 millions.
Okay,
you can close. So you can see their property, plant and equipments. They are investing only 700,000 in the property plant, which means property plant usually means the production facilities, correct? And Samsung has 104 billion and Lenovo has 1.4 billion. And the next line is 80% the sales generated compared to the total assets. So now you can see here, if the one company has $104 billion of assets, or their total profit is 101, right? But one company is making $1.43 billion in asset, and they are making $7 billion. So what? Which one is more efficient? Where you see the more efficient use of their property, plant, and equipments? Lenovo is better. What about Xiaomi? Well, actually Xiaomi is better, right?
Yes.
Only this year they have minus because they have a net actually it's a one line I hide it. It was net profit. Their net profit is negative this year in Xiaomi. So that's why it's shown negative, but ideally they are better. But look at now add the total non-current assets, means other assets which are not property, plant and equipment. So if you look at their balance sheet, you will see there are other assets other than non-current assets which are existing on their balance sheet. So here you can see 5 billion 104 149 and 1483 and 13. Do you have a balance sheet?
I have the balance sheet actually. Let me show you the balance sheet, then you will be able to see it clearly. Just one, maybe Xiaomi.
So here you can see here comes land use right, property, plant and equipments, intangible assets and investments. So you see the total non-current assets, they have 5 billion. This is in RMB, so don't get confused. I converted into dollars, but this is in RMB. But relatively, you can see the total property, plant and equipment is 5 billion. They have land use rights, which is 3 billion. Does land use right is earning them anything? Maybe not. We don't know. Maybe they built something. What other is there? They have other income, which is long-term investments, nearly about 18 billion. So instead of investing the money into their own business, what Xiaomi is doing, they are putting the money into other businesses. So that's why their return on equity or return on the assets is very low. Compared to their return on assets is 9% here. Xiaomi, Lenovo is even worse, 2% only. Samsung is better in 13% in total return on total assets. Okay, so why Lenovo is so bad? Because Lenovo is also the same story. Lenovo is also earning, they also have the other assets which are not relevant to their business. They have other assets other than what they are using in the business. You see, intangible assets. What are intangible assets? IP rights, trademarks, patents, goodwill. So what Lenovo has done is they bought companies for a much higher value than their book value. So when you consolidate the balance sheet of two companies and the investment in the company is higher than the book value, so it results in goodwill, something called goodwill. Yeah, so goodwill is means like the goodwill. English, what is the English meaning of goodwill? Yeah, like a brand value, right? So if I know that this class is worth $10 in the market, maybe it has a brand somewhere, but it doesn't change the cost, right? The cost still remain the same 10. But if I am able to sell this for 100,000, so what is the now what is the balance? What is the difference? What did I pay for? 100,000 minus 10. So what I did? What did I pay? 99,990. I paid for what? Brand or emotion or value that I see for future. So that is called goodwill. When you pay a price higher than your market value or your worth, it means you are paying for a goodwill or for a brand value. So that is the asset that they are holding in their books. So in their actual assets are only this property, plant and equipments. The rest of the assets are prepaid lease payments, construction in progress and intangible assets. Those are not directly generating any profits for you. So that is why you will see a difference in their return on assets. Return on asset is only 2%, return on asset is only 9%, but for Samsung return on asset is very high. Why? Because they are an established company and they are not investing into the unnecessary assets. Okay, and then again return on equity. So total equity for Samsung is 225.10 and for Lenovo is 4. So now you can see which company is using more debt. Can you tell me which company is using more debt? How will you know? Total assets minus total equity. What is the debt of Xiaomi?
Is it total asset minus?
Yes. 10, right? 10 million. Okay. And what is the debt of Samsung? 308 minus 225, 75, right? So if you see as a percentage, they have equity of 10 million and they have debt of 10 million, means half, right? Samsung has 75 debt, 225 investment. So around 3 to 1, right? Out of total 300, so their share is 25% debt, 75% their own money, correct? For Xiaomi is 50-50, half investment, half loan. For Lenovo, 29 minus 4,
25.
So where the money come from? 25? Debt. So how much percentage is the debt? They are reverse, right? 75% debt, 20% our own investment. So they are maintaining the higher invest. So now what is the result on the return results? So their return on equity is very high, correct? Because they are not using their money. So when you are not using your money and you are getting cheaper loan, so your return on equity will be higher. Versus if you have a higher interest rate and your return on assets is low, then your return on equity will be very low. In 1 month you can see is a minus, right? Reason being, maybe their income is not enough, so they are paying higher interest. So what happened to the return on equity? Become negative, correct? Return on asset is still there, the net income is still there, right? But total income is, return on equity is gone. Same for Xiaomi, is dropped significantly here. Okay, so this is how the return ratios works and what they display to you.